Before we get started this evening, I'd like to recognize a few people who made this all possible. First of all, to my wife, Maria Anna, for the support that she has given me. Also to everyone whose knowledge, expertise, and time has been instrumental throughout this process. Vince Barber, Ken Farina, not here tonight, Dr. Sandra Nicosia, and to all the other people that I may fail to mention. And a special thanks to the Italian Club for hosting this event. And a very special thanks to Roberto Tagliero to have made this happen. We wanted to thank the Consul General d'Italy, Mr. Musillo, and the President of the Italy-American Chamber of Commerce, Southeast, Mr. Cardano. I would like to introduce to you Mr. Musillo to make the first presentation, and after Mr. Cardano will tell us about the program of the IACCME, Italy-American Chamber of Commerce, Southeast.
Good evening, everybody. Okay. It's really a great pleasure to be here this evening. To be here last night, it was an amazing night. I'd like to thank again, first of all, the Consul General Cristiano Mugito, that is giving an amazing and wonderful support to the activity of the Chamber, not only in this trip, but since he arrived in Miami, and I'm sure that we're going to be doing the same for the rest of these years in Miami. I'd also like to thank very much both Mario Plaza and Vince Pardo for their amazing support, their passion about this project, and thanks to them we are all here tonight, and we are all here trying to make something happen. Which in my case would be create a business community in the Tampa Bay area for Italian company or for American company that look at Italy as a market opportunity. I just want to give you a few information about what the Chamber is, what the Chamber does, and how we structure, so to better understand what we can organize here in Tampa. The Chamber has been founded in 1991 in Miami, so we have 25 years of experience in these activities. So the Chamber is part of a network of five chambers in the U.S., New York, Houston, Chicago, and Los Angeles, and we cover the Southeast, which is Florida, Georgia, South Carolina, Alabama, Mississippi, and Puerto Rico. It's a network that also includes three chambers in Canada and one in Mexico, and overall about 56 countries around the world. The Chamber is a non-profit organization. This is another big difference. We are not a public, we're not a government agency, we're not a public structure. We are a non-profit organization made by entrepreneurs, made by business leaders to service the Italian American community in the Southeast. And there are some employees at the Chamber in the office in Miami, and there's 11 board of directors that have been elected every 3 years by all the members, and they dedicate their time, their resources pro bono to the Chamber and to the project. And then inside of the board of directors, they elect some executive person, like the president, the vice president, so. Right now, we are at 255 members. Has been a record high for the last 7 months, which means that we are doing the things, I think, in the right way. And these members are distributed between the Southeast, but also Italy. In our region, we have a few chapters. We created a chapter in Charleston, South Carolina in 2012. we create a chapter in Puerto Rico in 2015. We are now in the final stage to create a chapter in Atlanta, Georgia. And we are the Chamber of Southeast, and I think the Southeast would not be properly represented without a chapter also in the Tampa Bay area. And I really count on your support to make this happen in hopefully in the next month. These are some of the members of the chamber. They go from very large companies like American Airlines, Jazz, MSC, and others, to even small business, restaurants, or people that they want to start their activity in the trade with Italy or have some investments related to Italy and the US. We also have three representative offices in Italy that they serve as antenna to as a point of reference for Italian companies who want to come abroad. So we have an office in Milan, one in Bologna, one in Rome, that help filter the request of companies and support them in their process of going international. And to support this project, last April we did a Florida roadshow in four cities, Milano, Bologna, Firenze and Roma, presenting them the opportunities of the market in the Southeast and the opportunities for the companies to come over there. It would be something very interesting to repeat, offering them also as a future market, the possible market, the Tampa Bay area. Like I say, there are five chambers in the US, three in Canada and one in Mexico, beside the other approximately 60 in the other 55 countries around the world. The chamber is a non-profit independent organization, but is part of Asso Canalestro, which is the association of all the Italy binational Chamber of Commerce of Italy, which is Italian American in the US, but then it could be Italy, France, Italy, China, and so on in the different countries. And Asso Camerestro is also part of Union Camere, which is the organization that get together all the Chamber of Commerce in Italy and the Chamber of Commerce abroad. Who are our partners in our activities? We have local activities and local events that we organize, but also we create events with our international partners. International partners are usually port agency in Italy, Chamber of Commerce in Italy, trade show in Italy that have interest in our area, and we organize some activities. We focus our events on some what we call signature. We have three signature events, and this is what's happening in Miami right now, what has been happening in the last years. The idea is to try to replicate some of these events in other areas, the areas of the chapters, or create new events that are more focused on the needs on the chapters. Right now, our top signature events are the Authentic Italian Table, which is an event that happens every year. This year is going to be November 20. Together with the consulate in a spirit of collaboration and create a win-win relationship and synergy and working together. Where we're going to showcase the best of the Italian cuisine in a way of the gastronomic market, but also in a way of the supply that goes into this market, and also in a way to educate the customers from the difference between the true Italian products and the something Italian. Not to say that one is better than the other one, but just to explain the difference between mozzarella di bufala and a bufala coming from California, or a parmesan from Wisconsin, and a parmigiano reggiano from Italy. So we have some seminars, but also some social events and some testing moments. Another big event would be the Italica Award, which is basically a gala event that we have every December, right before the festivities. But it also is a moment to award some personality that dedicate their business life and their time to take the name of Italy around the world and to support the excellences of Italy across the world. And the last event is the last in a chronological order because it just happened. It's the Best of Italian Design. It's an event that we organized. Again, it was very successful this year, together with the the Consulato Generale in Miami is the best for Italian design. An event focused on design, but also food. It's an event that this year was two days event at the Miami Design District, and he was inviting architect and interior design with a tour with the different showrooms from Italian brands, and also creating like a food competition. The first day, and the second day we have some workshop and presentation and seminars. These are some ideas that I want to give you to you. First of all, to you be invited to come to Miami and be part of this event, but also to give you some ideas of what it can be replicated here in Tampa. Also, we have some events that are just smaller events, and are events that we repeat every month, every quarter, depending on the time of the event, and also depending on the season. Usually, summer is a little bit slower, so we do probably one every 3 months, and in the fall and the winter, it's almost every month. Our business breakfast, where our members get together at the beginning of the day in smaller groups, they present each other, and they probably present business opportunity among them. Business seminars are seminars that we organize with some of our partners, that sometimes are members of the chambers, and they are on specific topics. We did some seminars on the new tax regulation, fiscal laws. We did some seminar on the logistic and the trade, what do you need to have in order to import. We did some seminars with Custom and the FDA, so with some very specific topics that are requested by our members. And Meet the Expert is another very interesting event that we started doing last year, together with other binational chambers in Miami, with the Spanish chamber, the German, the French, and the British, where each chamber brings to in a space, that could be a space like this, an expert in one topic. And we create like an event in one evening where business leaders come and they have this possibility to talk with this expert and develop some topics, some projects in a very social and in a very casual way. And it's also a way for this expert to get known to the community of a different nationality. The same thing with the European chambers, we do some networking events, and we do another thing that we are starting to develop, and some seminar on technology, which is very important. And of course, one of the best reasons why Italy is known is the food and the gastronomic, and one of the activities that we have is the Marco Ospitalità. It's an award from the Italian government that recognizes all those restaurants that are truly Italian. And is a procedure that the Italian-American Chamber of Commerce carry on to recognize the true Italian restaurants and give them an award of plaque with a ceremony once a year. So what's the real value of becoming a member of the Chamber? The biggest value of becoming a member of the Chamber is the network that the Chambers can create. Like I said, it's not only a local network, but it can be a network throughout the US, but also outside of the US. Our mission is just to foster the trade between Italy and the US, and to foster and promote investment and the export. From Italy to USA, but a lot of time also from American companies that want to go to Italy. Basically, our main objective is to fulfill and satisfy requests from entrepreneurs and create a comfortable environment for them to do business and to promote their business. And as a matter of fact, in this way, one of the last initiatives of the Chamber, since we moved to a bigger office in Miami, was to create what we call a Project Italian Lab, which is basically an incubator for Italian companies that want to come to the US, and they want to be introduced in the Italian environment and get a push and grow faster. Right now we have a couple of companies in different industries, from the electronics, from the fashion, that basically have a space inside of the chamber, and they can we can help them grow in the market. We have three different level of membership: business, sustaining, and premium. And there are different level of visibility in events and in the tour of the chambers. And this is our contact of the chamber. So this is just a brief presentation to give you the details on how the chamber works, who we are, and what we do. What we are trying to achieve here. I've been last night from this perception that we had, and I really discovered this huge Italian community here that are over 100 years of history, and there are also a great business community that I haven't seen such a history of Italian-American community in our area. I don't think there's no other area. So we really, I really think that this is the perfect place to create another chapter for the chamber, but it's something that needs to be created with the local contribution on each of you, each of the company present here, because like I said before, we are a non-profit organization and we base our structure on the support of the member and on the membership. So it's the membership keeps the chambers running, and thanks to the commitment of our members, we are able to create events and to promote each other businesses. So the idea is to create a group of 15. We can create by our guidelines a chapter with 15 members, but I'm sure we're gonna reach this target very quick here, and we have much more members. So the idea is to create a group of business leader here that can be a point of reference for the business community, and all the support and the experience and the know-how the chamber in these 28 years of activities, and be able to create synergy with the business community, not only the Italian one but also the other communities, and create events, promotion, and basically a network that can be beneficial for everybody. And I'm talking only on the business point of view, but in these 2 days we see so many opportunities also on the science, on the education, on the cultural, and I'm really, really excited about what can be done here and in this market, and I really look forward to see you guys in part of the chamber and in one of our next events that can be organized here. I don't know if this one has some is connected to the internet or not, the Wi-Fi. Okay. Because I can, we have a video that presents the Italian American Chamber of Commerce, some of the activities. So if you want, if you give me your contact information, we could be more than happy to share your also YouTube channel with all the videos that gives you an idea of our events and what we do. Thank you very much for your time, and I'm available for all the questions that you may have for this project. Okay, at the end we're going to have a question. Thank you. Thank you.